like to introduce myself. My name is Matthew, or better known as Anna from Fragranica. I do fragrance reviews. Today I'm going to be doing my first real video review on my friend Tony's channel for Giorgio Armani's Acqua di Gioia. This fragrance was released in March of 2010 and was created by Locke Dong and Flippo and Dominique Repon. I think that this perfume is an excellent example of a unisex summer fragrance. Here is the bottle. It's quite beautiful. I wouldn't say that it looks like water, but it is very elegant, flowing, unified, unique. It's a nice work of art. It's pleasant to look at, and it looks great on my shelf. You can get this in a 30 milliliter, which is a 1 ounce, a 50 milliliter, which is a 1.7 ounce, and you can get it in a big 100 milliliter, which is 3.4 ounces. It comes in two concentrations, a hair mist, which I consider an eau de cologne, and an eau de parfum. I have the hair mist because it is not that expensive, and today, before I did this review, I compared it to a sample of the eau de parfum, and they're actually exactly alike. I actually think the hair mist projects a little better. Prices, it's a Giorgio Armani. You're going to find some weird prices online, but most of the time you're going to be buying, like I said, $25 to around $80. I think that a woman or man any age can wear this fragrance because it's a fresh fragrance. It's salty and saline. I would go with around 4 or 5 sprays on your pulse points, your chest, and perhaps your hair. The notes consist of the top, which is lemon and mint. The middle is jasmine, red peppers, and peony. And the base is labdanum, cedar, and sugar. I would be inclined to proclaim that the title suits. This fragrance is very refreshing, fruity, and floral. I simply can't get enough of this masterpiece. It's like a horrible addiction. So bad that every time my boyfriend and I are even close to a Macy's or Bon-Ton, I'm mentioning how I can't wait to smell Acqua di Gioia. I think he may be happy I've bought myself a bottle. The top is dominated by a chilled, ripe lemon and a squeeze of bergamot. Chilled as well, of course. I really enjoy the lemon in this one. It isn't that typical grocery store produce section lemon smell. Lest we forget the mint, probably giving the lemon its chilled effect because I don't necessarily smell it on its own. The heart is smoothed by a powdery jasmine, which again, I can't get enough of. I'm a jasmine addict. There's also some pink pepper, giving that slightly sweet vegetal dirt-esque plant smell, and peony provides an exciting, almost ADHD floral vibe. The base is intimidating with its super realistic sugar note, its sun-drenched cedar, and syrupy floral labdanum. The sugar note is simply spot on, and I would encourage you to go and open your sugar jar and take a whiff. You'll understand what I mean. This scent is amazing. The smell is a 9.5 out of 10, the longevity is a 6, and the sillage, while it's lasting, is definitely an 8. Acqua di Gioia by Giorgio Armani is a great release, and I'm hoping to see some more of this type of quality from them soon.